Thank you. Welcome back to another episode of our Genesis Kids online service as we continue our series, 5K. All week long, we're making the connection between commitment and God's character as shown through God's big story. If you really want to fully experience faith, you must practice your faith, and that takes commitment. Now let's get ready to run the race.
Hey there, I'm Jesse, and I'm training for a 5K race, and it's taking a lot of commitment. Commitment is making a plan and putting it into practice. There are so many things to think about with a training plan. Racing just doesn't work your legs, it takes your whole body. It takes your eyes, or even your ears, so you can listen well for the starting horn. Seriously, if you don't listen, you can get off to a late start. You see, our ability to listen well can make a huge difference in everyday moments. Not only that, but our ability to listen well can also help us hear things that God wants us to hear. In today's story, you'll hear a parable that Jesus told about one guy who listened well and one guy who didn't. Let's listen together to this story.
The Bible. It's 66 books of history, stories, letters, and poetry that fit together to form God's one big story. The epic adventure of how he created us and loves us so much that he made a way to rescue us. As we travel through the Bible, from Genesis to Revelation, we discover people who met God and found their lives changed forever. Now, for an amazing story, inspired by the book of Matthew, chapter 7, verses 24 through 29.
After Jesus was baptized and spent time alone in the wilderness, he returned to Galilee. There, he began teaching and gathering his disciples. Great crowds began to follow Jesus everywhere he went. So one day, he climbed up a mountainside and sat down to teach his closest friends. Many others showed up to listen.
You are the light of the world.
This is quite the sermon.
On the mount.
Jesus shared all kinds of wisdom about the way God wants us to live. He finished with a vivid word picture.
So then, everyone who hears my words and puts them into practice is like a wise man.
If Jesus gave us this example today, it might sound something like this. There were once two men who got an excellent deal on fabulous beachfront lots. One wise.
What of you?
And one, well, foolish.
Ooh, now I can swim with the sharks before breakfast.
They both drew up plans for their dream home. But the wise man surveyed his property carefully.
Better build back from the beach a little. Looks like we've got solid rock up here for the foundation.
The foolish man had other ideas.
I want one of those amazing beach cottages where the fish swim right up to your door.
But both men got to work. The wise man met with the builder for his new home.
I'd suggest steel beams.
Can you bolt them directly into the rock?
Absolutely.
Excellent. Let's go.
The foolish man, once again, had other ideas.
I like to think of my home as a work of art. Build it only out of things you find on the beach. Driftwood, shells, oh, dried seaweed.
You want me to build you a house out of seaweed?
You can braid it or something.
I'd suggest something more durable for the foundation, like a rock.
Don't be so stuffy. We're creating art!
Well, okay.
At last, the two homes were complete. The wise man moved into his home high up on the rock.
Good book, fresh lemonade, salty sea breezes. I'm all set.
The foolish man moved into his house right on the beach.
Seaweed thatching, exquisite driftwood posts. Shell columns? I am a true artiste!
Within a short time, dark clouds begin to form on the horizon.
Looks like I better pull down the storm windows.
Oh, goody. I can enjoy the gentle rain on my driftwood porch while communing with the fish at my doorstep.
The winds began to pick up. Raindrops spatted against the shore. High on the rock, gale force winds battered the wise man's home, but it stood strong and sturdy. On the beach, though, waters began to rise.
Yippee! I get to have one of those tropical huts with the water underneath, yeah!
The winds and waves beat against the foolish man's house.
Where did I put my magic rainbow sin umbrella? I'm just gonna get out of here.
The waves sucked away the sand beneath the house, and the wind whipped against the tipsy driftwood frame, and the entire structure collapsed. The foolish man stood drenched on the beach, staring at the remains of this house.
Oopsie.
On the mountainside, Jesus explained exactly what it all meant.
So then, everyone who hears my words and puts them into practice is like a wise man. He builds his house on the rock. The rain comes down, the water rises, the winds blow and beat against that house, but it does not fall. But everyone who hears my words and does not put them into practice is like a foolish man. He builds his house on sand. The rain comes down, the water rises, the winds blow and beat against that house, and it falls with a loud crash.
The crowd listening to Jesus stared in amazement.
He teaches with authority, like he's really in charge.
Yeah, nothing like the other teachers.
Jesus had spent the entire day explaining the way God wants us to live. His closing word picture made it clear. Anyone who puts the teaching of Jesus into practice builds their life on a foundation that will always stay solid, no matter what storms may come.
When you are training for a race, you need to hear what's around you. When you are training for life, hearing is a lot more than just taking in some sounds. You need to learn how to hear from God. But how do you do that? So how do you hear from someone who is big and far away? Here's what's cool. God is big. That's true, but he isn't far away. His son, Jesus, made it possible to have a one-on-one relationship with him and God. God gave us a way to hear from him anytime we want. This book, the Bible, is filled with the words of God, written down by many different people over hundreds of years. Reading the Bible is one of the best ways to discover what's true and what's important. It can help you know God better, and it can help you see if there's something in your life that you need to change. You can hear from God like this, or you can hear from God like this. You can hear from God through songs, other people, and maybe even in nature. So practice hearing from God. Read your Bible or have someone read it to you. If you don't have a Bible, or if you have questions about what you should read, ask a small group leader or someone you trust. They will be excited to help you build your training plan to help you hear from God. So here's two things to remember this week. Practice hearing from God. When you practice listening to God's word, it can help you discover what it looks like to love God and love others each day. Secondly, practice your memory verse of the month each day. Remembering God's word and hiding it in your heart is one of the most important things you could ever do in life. This month's verse comes to us from 1 Timothy chapter 4, verse 8. Now here's your challenge. Go find a Bible and look up this month's verse. After reading your verse, talk to someone you trust about what that verse means and how you can apply it to your life. Today, this week, and even this month.
Verse of the month. Training the body has some value, but being godly has value in every way. It promises help for the life you are now living in the life to come. 1 Timothy 4:8. Friends, remember to practice your memory verse every day, and we can't wait to see you next week.